Kumari, that's about 2.5 hours drive out from the city center of Cape Town. Say hello, ladies. Assalamualaikum. Yeah, so alhamdulillah, you know, we've been having a really good time. Everyone has been really treating us so well, mashallah. Hopefully we want to come back again, and really looking forward to the safari, and mashallah, the view outside here is beautiful.
Good morning, everyone.
Morning.
Good morning.
Warm welcome to Akula once again. My name is Timothy. I'll be your guide for this 2.5 hour game drive. Can anyone tell me what the word safari means?
Travel.
Yes, also Swahili or old Arabic word, it basically means to journey or to travel. Now that's what we're going to do. We're going to take a little journey through the wild, see if we can find some animals. Now at this stage, I can't promise you that we will find all the animals, but I will do my best to see if we can find some of them. Main idea, sit back, relax, and enjoy it.
Thank you. Elephants actually has a very, very huge and large brain. And elephants also actually have a very good sense of smell and a good sense of hearing, of course. As you can see with their long trunks, of course, they have a good sense of smell. Now, every human, every animal, even a plant or a bug actually has a type of scent inside of their body, which they remember and actually stored in their subconscious mind. So if you did something, let's say mana, you did something bad to mana, and you're 20 years from that time, you're gonna come back. It's something, if you smell that scent again, something triggers a memory. And believe me, he's either gonna hit you with a trunk, run over you, or press his tusk right through your body and scrape you on the ground. Of course, eland, biggest antelope in Africa. Also the very sacred animal to the Bushmen or the sand people. They actually hunted these animals for the fat, the blood, and the meat. Can anyone tell me why a zebra has stripes? Now the reason is main predators like your lions can only see in black and white. So if there's a dazzle of zebras standing around, they run clockwise, anti-clockwise, or towards each other. It's trying to confuse that predator. Zebras can actually kick 4 times harder than a horse. So do not attempt to ride one.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين ما شاء الله. We have a beautiful scene once again here in this beautiful part of the world, in the Cape region of South Africa. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for bringing us here, and here we are in the wild with all the wild animals in this beautiful safari park. And at the same time, it's important for us to take a look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches us when it comes to animal and when it comes to human being, the relationship that we're supposed to be having, and at the same time, the lessons that we learn from animals. Firstly, Allah's created us different from animals in two main ways. Allah says, لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. We have created mankind in the best of postures, which means the posture we have is better than any animal. If you take a look at all the animals we saw just now, we've noticed that they are on all fours, and at the same time, they have difficulty sometimes walking in terms of the terrain they can cover. Allah's made them in such a way that they can adapt to where they are supposed to be living, their natural habitat. When it comes to man, we have the best posture, where our eyes are positioned, the nose, the mouth, the hands, the fingers. Everything is absolutely perfect. He challenges us when he says, I've created mankind in the best possible way. And one of the reasons of or one of the points of benefit by looking at animals is to be able to appreciate what Allah has bestowed upon us. The second thing is the brain, the mind. Allah's given us the best brain, the best possible brain. We might have elephants and the other animals that we saw today, they have maybe better memories, but that's only a certain aspect of the memory, perhaps the length of the memory. When it comes to the brain of man, it is a sophisticated mind that can process things that are seen, things that are heard, in such a way that it develops that man in such a beautiful way. The second point that's very interesting for us to raise is when Allah speaks about those who call out to deities besides Allah, He then says, إِنْهُمْ إِلَّا كَالْأَنْعَامِ بَلْ هُمْ أَضَلُّ سَبِيلًا, where Allah says, those people are similar to the cattle. In fact, they are worse than cattle. Cattle here referring to general animals. The reason is, if you have an animal and you are to feed it every day, or it recognizes and it would recognize a point of goodness, every day it's getting food from a certain point, it will find itself there at that time with that person. It will know, this person brings me goodness, it won't harm the person. But the day it feels threatened, everything changes. So the animal understands the source of goodness and the source of evil. An animal would recognize very easily where it is supposed to go, what it is supposed to do. And at the same time, what we realize is, with us, we look at these animals, we enjoy, we see, we are fascinated, but the lesson we learn is supposed to be far deeper than just watching, seeing, and being fascinated. So Allah says, these animals recognize the source of goodness and evil. Why does man not recognize the source of goodness and evil? Here is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has provided, He has given, He has bestowed, He has blessed. Why then do we find ourselves calling out to deities besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a lesson. I think as we proceed in this beautiful safari park, I think it's important for us to consider these points and to be able to develop ourselves. Wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad. Sometimes people go hunting. If they're going hunting for fun, we would tell you as Muslims that is prohibited.